I'm running it off. I wake up.
What up, YouTube? Welcome back to another Stump Lot Seat Time series episode 2. So hopefully you guys enjoyed episode 1. I know that one was a little bit long. I'm gonna try to make this one a little bit shorter. The idea of this series, if you're new or haven't watched the first one, is to show you my progression on certain type of stunts. You go in there to progress something. So tonight I'm gonna focus on stand-up circles because I'm still a little sore from the sit-downs. I'd like to do the sit-downs when I have someone here. I'm gonna be solo tonight. Let's try to get my circles nice and tight. In addition to that, a little later I'm gonna stop, get off my Grom, and tell you about all my parts that I have on this. There's a lot of parts on here you might be interested on, so we're gonna go through today, make it a little interesting. But right now we're gonna warm up with some stand-ups. Try to cut her in now. So one thing a little unique about my setup is this big DSLR bag where I put my camera when I'm taking photos. I put it back on here because the majority of the big group rides I go on, I have this on there, so I have to get familiar with how it kind of affects my ability to do stunts. If I turn all the way, it has a little bit of resistance here from the bungee that's holding it in place so it doesn't flop forward if I do like a stoppy or flip. It's minimum, but it is noticeable. If you take it off, it's a lot easier to do certain things. Right where she's parked, if that's the cleaning lady, then yeah, it's a she, but right where she's parked, I assume, is like the perfect flat spot on this little lot, so it's a little bit of a bummer that she's there. I wish she would have parked in a space. How rude. I gotta turn my idle up a little bit. She is still on stock idle right now. So hopefully you guys enjoyed episode 1, like I said. Little new series I'm doing, so currently under, COVID lockdown, so technically this is considered my outdoor activity. At least that's what I tell the cops when they come and ask me what I'm doing. I consider this like going to the gym or going to work out just on two wheels. And it is a workout. My legs are definitely sore. My arms are sore from the session a couple days ago. So I'm going to do like every other day or every like third day, hit the stunt lot up just to kind of work on something. And it's going to change just because, like I said, parts of your body get a little sore. And it's nice to just mix it up. I knew that was coming down like that. That's what happens. You go down like that, mousetrap, and then you start pulling muscles. Takes a couple days for that to heal. Let me take a hot minute to just talk about my Grom, since we got nice light here and whatnot. Turn her off. All right, first off, I want to thank you guys for watching this video. I know it's not the normal group ride videos that you guys like to enjoy to watch. It's a little bit, one-on-one, me and you guys. I appreciate if you guys take a moment to leave some comments down below, some critique, some questions, maybe that I can answer in a future video or respond to in a future video. In a little bit, I'm going to pull up the comments from the previous episode, which I just went live about 2 hours ago. So a couple comments coming through, so I'm going to reply to some of those. All right, let's talk about the Grom though. So 2017 Honda Grom. If you don't know, the 2017, the US to the 2020 and 2021 are exactly the same, identical when it comes to the style of the plastics and whatnot. Only thing that changed is ABS is available on the 18, 19, 20, 21s. The 17s didn't have the option for ABS. Besides that, just the colors change on the plastics, but everything else exactly the same. Another fun fact, the 14 and 15 Honda Groms, the original ones, have the same exact motors. The wheels change, but they're the same, so same size, everything like that, just different manufacturer. These are actually 14-15 wheels on there. They're a little bit stronger, a little bit easier to strip, but they're exactly the same. Don't worry about that. I have dirt tires on my original ones. You're not going to break them unless you do something really crazy. All right, let's work our way around. So obviously I don't have a headlight. That's probably the most noticeable one. If you're looking at a brand new Honda Grom, why does mine look so different? I did this on all my Groms that I've had so far. Three different Groms. So I'm going to show you guys a video. Stock to Not season 2 ended, gave away the Honda Grom there, but I did a whole video on how I did this, so I just have to edit it and put it on YouTube. But this is a Honda number plate style B. We cut a hole in it with a Dremel, put a Jeep fog light in there, wired it to the battery. There's a little switch right there, so that's the most noticeable. The biggest thing is when you loop out, you do a stoppy, a wheelie, these things, the headlight module, this whole thing shifts down, so your headlight's all jacked up. So if you're going to get serious about stunting and you're trying to learn I recommend just taking it off, putting one of these on. You can always put it back on if you like the stock style. Another thing very important, in my opinion, are these sliders here. So these are TST sliders. They're just little fork sliders. They do sell bigger metal ones that stick out to right here. The problem is if those hit first, past the aluminum of your fork snaps very easily. If it doesn't have this Durlin puck on the end, if it doesn't have this little guy right here, it's gonna snap this. So if this hits before your bars or your sub cage or your exhaust, this is 100% gonna snap. But these are little Durlin sliders. You can see mine's a little scuffed up. Just take the brunt of the impact and just wear down. And these are replaceable. All right, then I wrap my forks with just some vinyl wrap, car vinyl wrap. So I got rid of the gold. This helps the black and white theme tie together. Got the EBC wave rotors up front just to help with a little braking power. Korimoto stainless steel lines in the front and also the rear and the handbrake. So stainless steel lines, what happens if you don't know, if you pull in your brake, you have the fluid going through there, and before it gets into the caliper, that brake line, which is made of like rubber, expands, and then the pressure gets there. With this, there's no expanding, so the fluid gets right through there. As soon as you press it, you got immediate pressure to your caliper. All right, moving right along, something I picked up on the coast-to-coast trip, the cross-country trip, very important, is a throttle lock. So basically, this will keep the throttle engaged. It's like a cruise control for motorcycles. Very simple. You just rotate it all the way back. Usually, you want to be all the way back with your throttle if you're using the cruise control. Rotate this down. It stops the throttle tube from rotating forward, keeping it like your full throttle. I leave it on the stunt bike because when I'm putting the camera away, you'll see me do it a few times. Nobody's in front of me, just so I don't do this like accordion action when, you know, I'm in group rides because people come up on you. So I can put the camera away and then maintain my speed, then just rotate it back. So just like that. You want to slow down, get the throttle back, you just twist the throttle forward, and then it's just like normal. All right, sitting on the bike, we have the DSLR bag, my quad lock phone mount here. This just hooks in like that. That's secure on there. Crashed with that many times. Got the one finger clutch pull here, the Elite Mototech. I've had that for a couple years now. I love it. I got an Adeline handbrake there, some pink pro taper grips on KLX 110 bars, pro tapers. Stock seat. I love the stock seat. So when I first got this, when I was learning wheelies, I didn't like it because it had the hump. Now that when you do sit downs, or when I do sit downs, I really like because it keeps your butt like right in that groove. So I like that, but they sell MSX 125 accessories, sells like straight ones and stuff. I had a bride one before, but it got super slick. This is nice and grippy, so I like that. I wrapped this black. So this is normally like gun metal gray. So I wrapped that black. These are a whole bunch of just little photography decals I have for my business when I was doing that. Z&Z rear sets right here. So these are so they don't break, aftermarket rear sets. Still got the stock exhaust for quiet. I just love how quiet it is, especially a stunt lot. It's nice not to be noticeable. I got the YSS rear shock here. This is the white one. I don't think they offer this anymore, but there is the red one with the piggyback. Same concept. I just like the white. I got the Manic Machining dual caliper bracket. So this is the two calipers. One goes to the foot brake here, and then one to the handbrake. So when you're doing wheelies, that's how you put it back down. EBC rear rotor, same thing as in the front. The NDC chain adjusters here with the spools, so you can pick it up and adjust the chain via that. I have Dunlop Scoot Smart tires on this guy, so this is what I use across country, Dunlop Scoot Smarts. I've been running for a couple years now. On the back, got the Get Bent Designs standard. It's just a standard length or whatever sub cage. They have different options now. They got like a 12, a 1, a short, a bend, all that stuff. But I just went with the standard. It's nice. Got the step plate, titanium puck. You can see my grip tape's kind of wearing out over here from too many double peggers. So I got to get more grip tape there, but again, has the Durlin sliders on the side, so that's what goes down. So therefore, it'll take some of that impact when you do go down. I can't really see it here, but I got the TST Industries tail light. So I did a whole video of that a few years back. Went over to TST and they put it on for me. Internally, I got a slipper clutch, so I got the Takagawa slipper clutch. I did that just because I was having so many clutch problems, but I really love it. So you can just downshift and don't have to worry about matching revs. You'll never have tire skip. Then I got those thick Thailand springs in there, the Koso clutch plate, the straight up pumps mod. That way, when I'm doing wheelies, it doesn't starve the engine. And then a 37 tooth rear sprocket and a 14 tooth front. So I went down one in the front and up three in the back. Really good for stunt lots type stuff. If you have any questions on this, leave a comment down below. I'll definitely answer your question in a future video, if not in the comments, if you're looking for an answer right away. There is a link down below to my kit. So if you go to my kit link, it'll just give you links to everything if you want to procure, if you want to purchase any of the stuff that I just mentioned. It'll give you straight links to all that. I get a little bit of commission from Amazon if you buy it from them. If it's like from get bent. I got a coupon code, but I don't get any money from it, but you save a few bucks. If you want to buy something, it's not going to cost you any more, like from Amazon, but I get a little cut from it for, I guess, recommending it or whatever. So it's kind of cool. I think I make like 80 bucks a month, so it's not like crazy money, but it, you know, any little dollar helps, especially when you're doing videos that YouTube doesn't like to put ads on. But anyway, that's it. Leave a comment. I'll answer it. Let's do some stand-ups now, and then I'll reply to some of your comments at the end of this video. And then I got a Chimera thumb screw idle adjuster. So it's on my throttle body. It's just a little thumb screw. They do sell like a long one, like for the CBR. But I'm bringing my idle up to about 3 right now. All right. Let's see how tight we can get these. See how that idle just... it's just pulling me across. I'm barely giving it any gas. I'm just tapping the brake. The idle's doing most of the work. So that's the benefit of like a higher idle. It makes it super easy when you just want to lay off the throttle and just worry about the brakes. So you kind of just get somewhat of a nice little throttle blip here, but nothing too crazy. One note, I'm running about 15 PSI right now. I kind of want to boost it up to about 20. I might try to juggle the PSI a little bit if I find that maybe it's, you know, it's kind of rolling on the edge. So if I hit the circle too quick and, you know, I start cutting in, it feels like the tire just gonna slide out, like kind of like drift out while you're up on a wheelie. And that kind of sketches me out if you get too quick around it. So I feel like if I have higher pressure, it might be a little bit better. I'm not sure if that's the case. If you guys know, by all means, let me know what you guys like to run. See, I gotta be careful with that hard brake. You heard the engine just kind of die out. That's when you mousetrap, and I've done it on this bike at this lot. I did a wheelie right here. I wish I could find the video. Just went up like this, went, and then grabbed too much handbrake, went boop, hit my head on the fender and then my head on the concrete. That's why I'm kind of sketched about doing too much crazy stuff out here by myself, because it actually really hurt.
Owie.
It was one of my more painful moments hitting the ground, and I wasn't going but like 4 miles an hour. Just mousetrapped and went straight down. You know, my hands, hold on a second, get back up here. My hands got all T-Rexed, and yeah, the only thing that stopped my fall was my helmet. So you don't want to kind of brace the ground with your head. You know, it's nice to slow down with your hands a little bit, but then your wrist get all jacked up. It's a pretty good little circle here, but here we go. Let me know what you guys think about the series, the mini series. This is probably not gonna continue, you know, past the summer, I don't think, unless you guys really like it. But let me know what you, if you want more talking, more just riding, like I don't even talk at all, I just start doing it and you kind of see the progression. Or do you want me to kind of talk and explain what's going through my head while I'm doing this? I know these are a little bit longer than very fun packed group rides, but this is kind of, you know, a little bit behind the scenes, I guess, if you're not into this, to wheelie practice. Just what it takes. So what I'm doing, you guys can see, I'm trying to put my left foot towards the edge of the peg. My right foot is towards the body of the fairing, or closer to the center of the bike. And my ankle slash calf is resting on that back piece of plastic back there. Just kind of using it as a little bit of a press. So I kind of just use my calf to press or lean against the body, the tail section of my Grom, as I'm putting the weight on my left foot, just to kind of get that turn. So what I'm doing is I'm pressing down with my left foot, and my foot's like this. Let me see if I can show you guys. Foot's like this, so it's more angled, and then once the bike comes up, this part of my my leg is pushing against this and the seat right here, and I'm just kind of hugging it and pressing a little bit as I go around to the left. So I'm pressing in to kind of get the bike to turn left, and I'm pushing down with my left foot more to the left here, more out, and then this foot more in, kind of like that. That's what's kind of kicking the bike to the left. And then I kind of juggle my body a little bit. I move my body left and right. You watch the shadows. That's kind of like the telltale sign from right here, until I get someone to record me from the outside. That's kind of how you have to gauge what I'm doing. But you'll see me kind of, I don't know if you can see my shadow there, but I'll be like, I don't know if you can see my arms, I'll be like moving my arms kind of like you're like running through a door, and you kind of just kind of dodge the door as you're running through like two of them at like an angle. I'm kind of, you know, dodging my body or moving my body around based on the balance. So basically I'm trying to keep the bike centered up but a little bit to the left. So I'll go like this. If it goes too far to the left, it feels like it's going to tip over, I move my body to the right, give it more gas to bring it back up. So it's crazy, man. It's so much. And this might be very advanced for where you're at, or it might be very beginner where you're at, but it's crazy. If I look back at like my beginning wheelies, just the concept of this is just so hard to explain. It's just such a feel thing. And it's not like anything you've ever done before, unless you've done wheelies on a bike. It's a whole new feeling. You know, and someone in their 30s like me, you know, that's a tough thing to get over. That's why foot brake's kind of hard for me, because spent my whole life, you know, leaning back in chairs, and when you're about to eat shit, you fall back on the chair, you do this, and you put your feet down to catch yourself. Whereas on a motorcycle, when you get past to the fallen part, past balance point or at balance point, you just tap the brake. That's it. And then you come back down, you got a magic button. If only like school chairs had that magic button, cafeteria chairs, to where when you're falling back, you just hit a button with your foot. I'd be knowing this stuff since I was like in second grade. That's something we need to get behind. Putting a foot brake on cafeteria chairs in elementary school. There we go. Here we go. And try to find my cut. Keep it up, keep it up, keep it up, keep it up, keep it up. Oh God. No one told you to park there. Yeah, this part's like so much smoother. All right, let's take a little break. Read some comments. Yeah, perfect. Whew. All right, let's see what we got. Ooh. Travis Tobias said, try what Brian 636 said, remove the foot brake spring. It'll take more of that squish away and more on and off. It may work for you. So, I don't know if he was talking about on the ground. So here's the spring. There's two of them. So if you remove these two, what the hell's gonna that control? So that one's for the sensor for the tail light, and this one is for. All right, let's just see what happens if you take that off. Let me see if I got a tool. Oh yeah, it still works. Okay, take this off and see what happens. I'm just gonna leave that dangling like that. That is like a rock though. Holy shit. All right, Travis, thank you for that. Running with Lee says, I swear the handbrake spoiled the shit out of me. I'm trying to make foot brake natural. Still trying to make it natural. Yeah, man. It's amazing how quick you get spoiled with the handbrake. It's just so intuitive because, again, your whole life, you're putting your feet down when you're about to fall. This, you just use your hand. A&D completed his first day at MSF school. Congratulations to you. He's going to get a ground. All right, they're gone. Let's continue. A couple comments. Leave a comment down below, question, whatever. I'll answer it, read it out on the next episode. See how this is for the foot brake. Oh my God, that's like a rock. That is like a rock. Okay. Can we do that while getting past balance point? That's the question. I don't know if you guys saw that, my little finger there. All right, we're gonna save this for a future episode. I got an idea for that one. Oh yeah, right here. I'm gonna have to put a no parking sign there. Grom circle wheelies only. There we go. All right, not so great, but better. All right, so my idea for the foot brake for next episode, let me know what you guys think. Instead of trying not to loop, I'm gonna try to loop. So we're gonna come out here or somewhere, and I'm gonna gear up, put the jacket on, maybe thicker pants, and we're just gonna try to loop. I'll get someone to record it so we get two angles, but I'm gonna give it all the sauce, let out the clutch, and try to loop it and see how hard it is to loop it. I'm not gonna stop until I loop it. I'm not gonna touch the brakes. I'm just gonna see how far back it really is, because my brain is all psyched out. I haven't had a good loopy in a bit. So that's what we're gonna do next week, or the next episode, episode 3. Stay tuned for that. Drop a like down below, subscribe if you haven't done so already, but please leave a comment of support. Let me know you guys still love these episodes. One to sit down. That was handbrake. All right, I'll see you guys in a couple days. Have a good one.